My name is Janet Kezengwa. I'm from Kenya. I'm a financial crime compliance investigator at a bank because I think I have a whole bunch of experience in terms of money laundering. But you know, corruption is a predicate offense of money laundering. So I really got interested in having to have that background on how we can, all these funds are channeled until the ultimate goal is the financial institution, whereby layers are created to disguise the origin of the source of the funds. So that is actually what made me to go back to the public domain and do my own entire research. And I came across this school, which probably has given me an insight, like a basic information about how corruption goes about. I believe, yeah, as much as we accept that corruption is a global phenomenon, right? But we still have those success stories whereby from where I'm seated or from as I go back home, I'll be able to think globally and act locally, filter in what is actually important to help me like drive my market or my country into a corruption-free. You know, we cannot actually eliminate corruption as a whole, but we can, we can like reduce or even bring it to a tolerable level.
Corruption,
I believe that we should start nurturing corruption at a tender age, because you know, we are a product of our society. We are a product of our society at the end of the day. So if we inculcate or incorporate the sensitization of corruption at a tender age, trust me, someone who's like 2 years right now, by the time that person grows up into a future leader, that level of integrity, that level of responsibility will be in that particular person, and it will make the person, a greater leader, and it will have like a sustainable, how can I say, passage throughout the generations.